who plays such a vivid part in the summit of this area, that it celebrates the home Davis 76 each year during the last week of July. This parade is coordinated with the aid of numerous volunteers, including ranchers who supply hundreds of horses. I want to thank each and every one of them, and also all the volunteers that are operators for our parade. The Davis 76 had its inception in 1923 when a local group of businessmen sponsored a day of races, contests, music, dancing, and fireworks on the 4th of July. The following year, it was decided to make it an annual event coinciding with the deaths of Waco Hickok and Calamity Jane. In June of 1929, the Davis and 76 Committee was incorporated. And since then, the committee and the former personnel contributed hundreds and hundreds of dollars to assure success. For more than 100 years, there have been rumors of gold and black hills of reported their occurrence, and in 1874, General William J. Custer confirmed it. And by 1876, the critical prospectors had turned into a avalanche. And they burned down Denver Gulf. I can't say it's very often tonight, and for more than the average share of fortune seekers, greenhorns, gamblers, dance hallers, and gunslingers, they have names like Katie McCown, Bridget Smith, Charlie Everett, Kitty Leroy, and of course, the world famous Wild Bill Hickok, Miami Dade. Also, the American flag flies on a pole up on a hill right up there, brown rocks above Edward, one of the most beautiful pictures you can have. The flag was flown continuously at this spot, overlooking the city ever since the Pearl Harbor attack. It reminds us again of our great greatness of our country, and we breathe the old prayer that it may always flow free and beautiful of us. Hats off to our self-footed governor, Mr. Radio VFW, Post 5969, Post 31. Brave men and women who serve this great country, you want to thank you very much for all your sacrifices, gentlemen and ladies. Next up, the first is Jerry Olson. Jerry entered his first rodeo at the age of 12, competing in bareback riding, saddle riding, and tie-down open. By the 50s, the Olson family had created a horse act that evolved into the very popular Buffalo Act, with family members riding a buffalo. Jerry continued that tradition as a main and was a main special act of the year 1983. He's the only one of three people who have competed at the National Finals Rodeo as a contestant and as a specialty act. And they're being pulled today by Bruce Grimm. Thanks, guys. The Davis 76 Committee. Two of our committeemen there now today are Roberts, Dunbar, Chris Roberts, Craig Howell, Bill Peterson, Pat Roberts, Gina Duke, Matt Meyer, Greg Nelson, Seth Thompson, Don Gross, Tim Conrad, Pat Claymore, Davis Rogers, Jim Brown, Nancy Mayer, Jimmy Nansen, and this is new member Jim Brown, who by the way has a birthday tomorrow.
Chris Roberts, look up.
You don't remember this year's chairman is Jim Nansen. Hey Matt, we're glad we get a horse on all 14 tonight this year. Who else we got down there? We got Jim and Matt. Next up, Chief Baldy. Well, has been the captain of the Davis 76 since 1928. At the age of 97 years young, he has traveled the world representing the Cheyenne River Shoot Track. Chief Baldy will serve in the 82nd Airborne Division during World War II, and it was last month was on D-Day. This is the 97th year it has participated in the days, and it is joined by family members, including Ziggy Baldy, O'Green, Eric Silverman, Wally, and Mikila, who are being pulled by Rick and Sally Miller. Chief Bald Eagle is being pulled by Jerry Niles. The team also has a beautiful line of jersey with them. Okay, and next to the rodeo queens, Miss South Dakota, Amanda Peterson. Miss Rodeo North Dakota, Anna Taylor. Miss Rodeo South Dakota, Lady in Waiting, Michaela Seach. Ladies of 76 is Pippi Kuzma. Miss Junior, Ladies of 76, Tyler Hans. Thank you. After having been married and had a slave, the crappy artist, under the direction of Randy Christensen, one of the most popular activities here in Edwards. Here's the Big Green Bag. Here's the Big Stage. There's the Edwards Stage.
Thank you.
Bashan group on the small stage. There was supposed to be two of them, and I know that's my friend. Or Jim Brad, I'm sorry. Thank you, John, Brian, and his family joining us for one long today. Coming back to Denver. He's been pulling the Concord stage for us today. And that's John is also joining the group.
And their four horses were named Ralph We've been focused.
Oh, this one's
Collie. You want to get from here to the Oregon ground, just simply grab the collie and they'll take you right down there. Well, park up here at one of the lots and jump on the collie. Head to the Oregon. And a big thanks to our firemen to keep us safe and let us sleep at night. Yeah.